stream of concerts associated with the 83rd convention of the American Bandmasters Association. Before I introduce this group on stage, we kind of have a tradition here of not talking during the concert, but there's one little thing we want to do. The group here that's on stage, of course, is from Tennessee. And as we remember, one of our great ABA members, past president and honorary life member, Jay Julian, was from Tennessee. And tonight, this group is going to premiere a piece that's dedicated to Dr. Julian. And with us tonight is Dr. Julian's son, Jeff. Jeff, would you please stand and let us recognize you for being here with us? Concert, the Dobbins High School Wind Symphony.
Thank you. Thank you. different location around somewhere different in the United States. So this is the first time in 87 years that the ABA convention has come to Kentucky. So we're really excited about that. Concert bands are the groups that perform indoors, and they're the band equivalent to what a symphony orchestra is to the orchestra world. These bands represent the finest musicians from their campus or from their communities. All of the American Bandmasters Association members who are able to come to this convention will be here. And they're coming in from 43 or so different states from throughout the USA and four different Canadian provinces as well.
Well, this is huge. First, I say this is huge. I mean, this is the top organization for band directors, composers. So in our world, we started this a while ago, probably a year in planning. So we've been just sort of behind the scenes working with just bus companies and all that, sort of getting everything ready. We have about 200 members flying in with their families.
A lot of them are active professionals. A lot of them are retired professionals. Military band directors from Washington, D.C., or any military establishments throughout the United States. The director of the United States Marine Corps Band will be here as well with his ensemble, but he's also a member of the ABA. So a lot of military people are in this organization. A lot of university and college band directors, professors, retired or active, are also in this group, and they're coming in from all over the country. High school, middle school, public school teachers, music educators who have been elected into this organization because of their lifetime achievements will also be coming in. So the United States Marine Band from Washington, D.C. is coming in, and they'll be performing on Friday night. They are generally considered the world's finest concert band. The last performance they had was on the steps of the Capitol building for the presidential inauguration. They do a lot of ceremonies in and around Washington, D.C. and throughout the United States.
But this is a great honor for this group to get that, you know, get that publicity out there. And for all these, you know, you hear about these conductors, these big names, and they're going to be here. And they're going to hear the group. They're going to hear, you know, University of Kentucky Wind Symphony. So I'm sure it's a great honor for the kids. They get to meet all these conductors and guest conductors coming in to work with them.
They're thrilled to be a part of this. A lot of them are helping out with all of the planning and the logistics and just the legwork that goes into pulling this all together. So they're very proud of what we're doing, and they're also excited to be involved in the entire process. And to be performing on the opening night is also going to be a huge thrill for them, because they can share their musical talents with what really is an international audience. And so they're very, very excited about that.
And this is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for the students, you know, and for us just sitting back. I mean, they get so many different perspectives, and they're all successful. So it's interesting to see just the different ways that they approach rehearsal, the different ways they approach performance. So that is going to be fantastic for them.
But the repertoire these groups perform will be wide ranging, everything from the old traditional Sousa marches to the newest cutting edge pieces to pieces from Europe, enjoyable music. I think the thing that strikes me about the programming for ABA for each of the groups is that the programs will have a lot of variation. There'll be a wide variety of pieces that the audience members will really enjoy. So it's more entertaining. It's going to be a lot of really good music.
Well, as far as the audience, I think they can take away just the caliber of ensemble that are going to be here. Ohio State's going to be here. Louisville's going to be here. All of these type, the President's Own Marine Band is going to be here. So just the awe from those, I mean, they're going to be incredible performances anyway. But the music, like I said, the programs are very diverse. You're going to find something that you can latch on to. And then there's, of course, going to be more cerebral pieces that are newer, a little bit more modern, and some of the old school. So it's going to be very balanced. You're going to enjoy it.
I think, more than anything, just the pageantry and the traditions of the ABA, it's a very historical organization. It is the most historically significant organization in the band world. And so they'll take that away from it as well. So I think it's a lot of things. By just coming to a concert, they'll be exposed to a lot of the traditions and the fine music, the artistry, all that coming together.
continue our concert this evening, would you please welcome the University of Kentucky Wind Symphony, conducted by Cody Burke.
Thank you. Thank you.